Assalamu alaikum, Tullab. Today I will talk about the practical aspects of Leishmania. I will start with life cycle nodes. This slide is for exam purposes. I will talk about the habitat, the definitive host, the intermediate host, the method of transmission, the infective stage, and the diagnostic stage of Leishmania. In case of Leishmania tropica, which is the cutaneous leishmaniasis, the habitat is the skin. The parasite is engulfed by macrophages of the skin. While in case of visceral leishmaniasis, the habitat is the organs of the lymphoreticular system, which includes the spleen, the lymph nodes, the bone marrow, blood. The definitive host, we have two hosts, and leishmania needs two hosts. The definitive host is a human being, while the intermediate host is sandfly. Method of transmission is by the bite of infected female sandfly. The infective stage is the promastigote, while the diagnostic stage is the amastigote. And we will talk about the promastigote and amastigote in details. The diagnosis, we need to take a sample. Then we need to examine this sample under the microscope looking for amastigotes. How do we take a sample from a patient with cutaneous disease? We take a skin biopsy or a skin or aspirate from the ulcer edge. We have an ulcer in case of cutaneous leishmaniasis. We have an ulcer. We either take a biopsy from the ulcer edge or we take an aspirate from the ulcer edge. And I placed a link so that you can see the procedure in more details. هذا اللينك إذا تروحون علينا ممكن أنه تشوفون البروسيجر بتفاصيل أكثر. In visceral leishmaniasis, we take the sample either from the blood and we examine the buffy coat of the blood, but this is not very sensitive. If we want to increase the sensitivity, we go to lymph nodes, bone marrow, or spleen. The bone marrow is more sensitive than the blood, and the spleen is more sensitive than the bone marrow. يعني sensitivity of the test in case of bone marrow examination, I believe it's around 75%. While in case of spleen, it reaches around 90%. But spleen aspirate is not the best. Why? Because if we take aspirate from the spleen, from a patient with Leishmania Donovani, we increase the risk of rupture, of splenic rupture. Patients with Leishmania Donovani, they have huge splenomegaly. So a spleen aspirate, although it's very sensitive, it's almost 90% sensitive, it increases the risk of rupture. After taking a sample from the patient, we put the slide under the microscope and we stain the slide with Gimze stain and we put it under the microscope looking for amastigotes. Presence of amastigotes on the slide diagnose Leishmania. Look for amastigotes inside mononuclear cells in Gimze stained slides prepared from the above samples. نجي على promastigote stage of Leishmania species. مثل ما قلت لكم هو ال infective stage of Leishmania وموجود بال sandfly. إذا ناخذه بتفصيل أكبر راح نشوف أنه شكله سلندر مغزلي الشكل. It contains a large nucleus that is located in or near the center. إما بنص الباراسايت أو شوية بعيدة عن مركز الباراسايت. Single nucleus. It has a structure that is called kinetoplast. Kinetoplast تكون من parabasal body والبليفاروبلاست. من الكينيتوبلاست يمتد الأكزونيم ومن الأكزونيم يمتد الفلاجيلا. الكينيتوبلاست بحالة البروماستيجوت موجود بالانتيريور end of the parasite. زين اذا ناخذ جيمز ستاند سلايد يحتوي على البروماستيجوت راح نشوف ان البروماستيجوت شكله مغزلي مثل ما تشوفون مغزلي سلندر شيب ات كونتينز ا سنجل نيوكليوس واضحه ات كونتينز ا كاينيتوبلاست ذات از لوكيتد ان ذا انتيرير اند اند فروم ذا كاينيتوبلاست اكستندز ذا فلاجيلا. مهم جدا انه تلاحظون ان ذيس سلايد ذير از نو ار بي سي اند ذير از نو monocytes, there is no macrophages. ليش? Because this slide is taken from the sandfly. مثل ما قلت لكم promastigote موجودة بالsandfly وهذا السلايد مأخوذ من sandfly. ماكو لا RBC ولا monocyte ولا macrophage. على العكس من الأماستيغوت. الأماستيغوت اللي يشوفونه بهذا السلايد، إذا نأخذ المورفولوجي of the amastigot. The amastigot is oval or round in shape. It contains a single large nucleus that is located eccentrically. يعني يحتوي على نواة كبيرة موجودة بالأطراف ما بالوسط. It contains also the kinetoplast. The kinetoplast being a parabasal body of blepharoplast. And from the kinetoplast extends the axoneum and there is no flagella. Flagella ما أكو بالأماستيغوت. إذا نأخذ الأماستيغوت in Gimse stain slide مثل هذا السلايد. This is Amastigot of Leishmania species. As you can see, the slide is filled with Amastigots. الأماستيغوت is rounded or oval in shape. بهذا السلايد it's oval in shape. It has a single large nucleus that is located outside the center. It contains the kinetoplast. ومثل ما تشوفون the RBCs is visible in this slide. ليش؟ لأنه مأخوذ من السبلين أو من البومرو أو من الليمف نودز. The RBCs is visible and the monocytes is also visible. فعنشوف المونوسايتس وعنشوف ال RBCs. هذا السلايد الثاني أيضا عن الأماستيغوت. هذا مأخوذ من سمير معمولة من سكن بايوبسي. فأماستيغوت of Leishmania tropica from an impression smear of a biopsy specimen from a skin lesion. يعني كان أخذوا بايوبسي من السكن وأخذوا السلايد وخلوا السلايد على على البايوبسي وداسوها. فهي سموها impression smear of a biopsy specimen from a skin. شوفوا إيش قد واضحة ال RBCs وإيش قد واضحة المونوسايت العفو الماكروفيج وإيش قد واضحة بداخل الماكروفيج النيوكليوس مع الماكروفيج وإيش قد واضحة أيضا الأماستيغوتس اللي بداخله. ف this is a macrophage. You can see the boundaries of the macrophage. It contains a large nucleus and the macrophage is filled with amastigots. The amastigot مثل ما تشوفوا إيش قد واضحة oval in shape. It contains large nucleus on the periphery and it contains kinetoplast. The amastigots will replicate inside the macrophage. The macrophage will burst. Amastigots will be released outside and it will infect another macrophage. And we come into a conclusion that diagnosis of cutaneous leishmaniasis needs examination of skin biopsy or aspirate from ulcer edge for the presence of amastigots, while diagnosis of visceral leishmaniasis needs examination of a blood, lymph node, bone marrow, or spleen aspirates for the presence of amastigots. And thank you for your listening.